You look gorgeous, by the way.
I tried, yeah. Just for you. There was a big debate. Red dress, black dress.
Doesn't matter, it's all
overall,
good.
They picked red. It's all in the hands of Twitter.
It's all good, is what I'm saying. So much to talk about. First of all, you have no accent whatsoever, but you're from Italy. Is that correct? You were born in Italy and lived as a youth in Italy? Is that true?
As a youth.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was born in Rome. Mm-hmm. I moved to the States when I was 8. I do not have an accent, which I know shocks a lot of people, except when I say Italian words.
When you say Italian words, you have the accent.
Correct.
So give me an example of, because right now I'm hearing nothing. You sound like, you could be from Iowa. I have no idea. But when you're in a restaurant.
Do I look like I'm from Iowa?
Well, sure, why not?
No, why not? Okay, spaghetti.
Oh, you say spaghetti?
Spaghetti.
I'd never heard anybody call it that. I thought it was spaghetti. Back me up on this, right? It's spaghetti.
Yes, and that is yes, and that is why there's always a big debate as it whether it's spaghetti or spaghetti.
Spaghetti.
In Italian, it's spaghetti.
So if you're in Italy, you should say, "I would like a big bowl of spaghetti."
Spaghetti. Correct.
Probably not a big bowl of. That doesn't sound right either. But spaghetti. Can I hear other pronunciations?
Spaghetti, linguini, fettuccini, farfalle, orecchietti, gubetti, that goes on and on.
It's very sensual, though.
Yes.
I like it when you...
Mascarpone, parmigiano, reggiano. Yes,
more,
you see,
please.
That's how I got my husband.
I like mascarpone.
A little bit of that,
mascarpone.
Yes.
Mascarpone! I'm going to start trying to pronounce everything like that. I really will. Now, you said your husband, your husband is he from Italy as well, or is he from...
He is not. He's from Michigan.
Oh, how'd that go over when you introduced him to your Italian family?
It took about, what have we been together now, 24 years? It took about 24 years.
Right.
Yeah.
For them to get used to him.
Yes.
What did he do that most offended their Italian sensibilities when they first met?
Well, I think the thing that embarrassed him the most and to this day still embarrasses him is when the first time I took him to my grandfather's house years and years ago, he served spaghetti and my poor husband asked for a knife and a spoon. He cut all the spaghetti and then he ate them with the spoon.
He ate that?
No, like,
you know
like,
what, I don't eat, what is he talking about? I haven't heard of anybody doing that. He chopped it all up into little pieces and ate it like a breakfast cereal?
Did you meet him when he was 6 years
old?
No,
I'm never gonna be able to go home tonight.
Yeah.
Okay, so yes, because I think, first of all, he was nervous, number
right.
one. And number two, I think he just was, he tried a couple of turns to try and get the spaghetti and he couldn't get it in his mouth, it kept falling off. He got irritated, he cut it up and he ate it.
Right.
And
is he allowed to eat spaghetti ever since?
To this day, he does not ever want to touch any spaghetti or linguine or fettuccine, ever. It's always short pasta in our house and that's that.
Beefaroni or beefaghetti, those are the ones I like. Right, USA.
Those are the words he liked too, so there you have it.